2014 started off with me being in between countries. Paperwork, visas, other crap. Yeah. Not knowing where you'll be sleeping in 1 month's time is quite the emotional roller coaster. I guess the rest of the year was that way too. Nothing to Hide went public in February 2014. It's a game I'm still working on, about social media and self-surveillance. Now, I put all of my eggs in that basket. I did all of the art, code, design, press for the game. I even made the entire crowdfunding website, like even handling the payment pledges. What was I thinking? All of those eggs in one basket turned me, Nicky Case, into a basket case. Ha ha! Rimshot. Laugh track. Scene fades to black. In March, I launched Sight and Light, an interactive tutorial on how to make the 2D lighting effect seen in Nothing to Hide. It was promotional material, and it helped Nothing to Hide's crowdfunder barely reach its goal. Sight and Light got really, really popular. Like, front page of Hacker News, Reddit, and Imgur simultaneously. That was uplifting. I was in a pretty dark place at the time, and Sight and Light let me see some light. People loved the Nothing to Hide demo, except for one thing. The story sucked. Major suck. Epic suck. Me drunk in a gay club in San Francisco, levels of suck. So in April, I wrote one short story a day to practice my story writing skills. One of the stories hit the front page of Reddit. Awesome. Sure, the karma was nice, but more importantly, this experiment got me to read and research real literature. 2014 was the year I finally broke out of my techie bubble and dove into the art and humanities. In May, we launched the Public Domain Jam, a hackathon for game developers to give and take from the public domain. I've been doing free culture activism for a while. All my games are public domain, so it was really great to help out the cause and also help support my fellow open artists. Then, another story writing experiment. This summer, I released Coming Out Simulator 2014, a half-true game about half-truths. It's an interactive story where you play as me coming out as bisexual to my Asian parent. Judging by the fact I made a game about it, didn't go so smoothly. But that project was the most meaningful game I've ever made. This one time I was just like reading through dozens of long emotional fan mails from queer folk all over the world. Some have come out, some haven't, and for some, my game was closure for them. My story made them cry. And reading their fan mail, I cry too. Softly though, because I was reading it in the public library. Then, I got thrown back and forth between countries for a couple months. Anyway, this fall, there were three events I was a huge part of, and or was a huge part of me discovering myself. Public Domain for the Win. Remember the Public Domain Jam? I spoke at this event, in collaboration with Creative Commons and the EFF, about public domain games. Sweet! Explorable Explanations. Remember Sight and Light? Brett Victor noticed it, and he really liked it, so he invited me to speak at this workshop about interactive web essays. Queerness in Games Con. Coming Out Sim got me a little bit of street cred here. Nice! And this con let academics and designers meet each other. And so, again, I learned a lot about the arts and humanities. Then I realized I wasn't really about games or startups or crappy self-made crowdfunding sites pretending to be startups. That's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted to have wanted. I did it because of the prestige or because I thought I was obligated or I should. So what do I really care about? Art and activism. And alliterations. Alliterations are always awesome. All that came together into my final project this year, Parable of the Polygons, a playable post about systemic bias and diversity. It's art, it's activism, and hot diggity damn, that's some good alliteration in that title, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, and I also made it in collaboration with freaking ViHeart! Ah! It's the most popular thing I've ever made in my life. In its first week, it got written up on Wired, Washington Post, New York Magazine, The Atlantic, Salon, and so on and so forth. Ah! And that's it! That's all my major projects this year. Here's a bunch of other small things I made. Social Mind Spying, my new website, this 2D Matrix toy, Riot's Cop selfies, Angry Physics, If Games Toys Were Like Games, 2.5D VR animation, this thing, and a neuron toy that helps you learn about learning. Also, on a more personal note, 2014 was the year I started lifting weights and wearing eye makeup, muscles and mascara. Why? Same reason I switched my name from Nick to the gender-neutral Nicky. I don't know. I'll probably figure it out in 2015. Anyway, pretty good year, right? So, why was I such a downer at the start of this vlog? Maybe it's burning out. Maybe it's seasonal affective disorder. Maybe it's because I'm the kind of person whose thoughts go from my water bottle's leaking a little bit, to I'm going to spill water at the gym, to someone's going to slip and drop their weight on my head, to I am going to die. In less than 5 seconds, that's my train of thought. I think though, it's because of the baskets. These fucking eggs in these fucking baskets. At the start of this year, I put all my eggs in one basket, nothing to hide. And then the eggs hatched, moved away, grew into full-grown hens, started producing their own eggs, and put them in entirely new baskets. The activism basket. The story-writing basket. The interactive arts basket. And I like these new baskets a lot more. The question now is, what do I do with all these old baskets? The startups basket. The video games basket. The nothing to hide basket. That's where I started off at the beginning of this year. And like, most of my friends and professional network are in the startups and games scene. I can't just leave them. And as for nothing to hide, I do still truly believe in the project. I really do. I've been working on it for over a year. I wouldn't have worked that long if I didn't believe in it. And it's, you know, it's my baby. And I'm a shitty parent. Sure, I did a lot on nothing to hide this year. Just not as much as I wished. It's always been my main project, but most of my success this year was through side projects. Side projects which pointed me in directions which I believe are better for me and my fans and the world. But nothing to hide was the reason I went down these new directions. I grew up in this basket. But I guess I just outgrew it. I don't know what to do. I mean, yeah, all the lessons I've learned from story writing and interactive design and arts and humanities and outreach and activism. All these lessons I learned from my side projects, I can apply to my main project, Nothing to Hide. I can remake this basket. I can make it a basket worthy of my eggs. Okay, yeah, this eggs and basket metaphor really sucks. Super sucks. Spectacularly sucks. Me drunk after finding out my visa is stuck in limbo. Levels of suck. 2014 ends with me being in between baskets, careers, identities, possible lives, and not knowing who you'll be in 1 month's time is, well, guess that's what 2015 is for, right? Happy New Year, everyone.